Good morning. Well, it's going some when you lose 35 pounds, then you're afraid to lose any more because you're medicated for blood pressure for that weight, and you're afraid that if you lose more weight, you'll be over medicated. I can remember my grandmother losing weight, and she had high blood pressure, and she'd go around and say, "I'm over medicated, I'm over medicated." People, they would say, "Well," but doctors don't have to deal with this too often, I guess, because I was very much afraid that my regular doctor, if I told him I thought I was over medicated, he would probably protest and say, "You're under. Let me give you another." But anyway, the doctor I went to this past week said to me, "I think you're over medicated." I've been waiting for a doctor to say that all my life. And he said that, well, what he had given me to, the main pill that he had given me to regulate my heartbeat, too much. So he cut a third of that. And then he cut two other medications and replaced them with another one. And so now I'm not going to be afraid to lose more weight, because when you get down so far and you know you have heavy blood pressure pills, that... That's just what you're afraid of. And so now I'm not going to be afraid to lose more weight, so that I will match up with my medication. So anyway, I am now less medicated, and we'll see how that goes. So if that's the case, then I intend to lose 25 more pounds, because I had gotten a lot of my eating of bad foods under control, so that I'm not as addicted to all of them as I used to be. Oh, heavenly days, I used to be so addicted to my bad foods that it's very hard for me to give them up. But if you work on it and work on it and work on it, you can gradually fight your failing. You just have to have a candy bar, a cookie, something, you know, that you know you shouldn't have. And so on. As I said, I've always done well in the not smoking, not drinking, but my mom had a big problem with this too, and she didn't ever tell us not to eat any. We could eat anything. We could eat sugar 10 times a day, and she wouldn't say anything. So, in the Mormon culture, smoking and drinking are high on the word of wisdom list, do not do. But as far as I don't know whether all of the bad foods are on there yet, because Mormons love to cook delicious food, and a lot of that is fattening, and so I don't know whether they've changed that or not, but anyway, I'm happy. And I will keep you informed as to how my struggles go to get better and better control of my weight. Thank goodness for that one smart doctor.